As a good Bengali, Dibakar, you just saw at the moment, you're not a good Bengali. No. You want to take the mic and say that loudly to a Bengali audience that Dibakar Banerjee is not a good Bengali?
No, I'm not a good Bengali. I'm a Probashi Bengali. So there are many, many, foreign influences in my Bengaliness. So
what do you think is actually, what makes a good Bengali? What's the distinction you see between a Probashi and a real authentic Bengali?
Language, because I think a Bengali who has lived in Bengal all his life will have a kind of language, a Bangla, which a Probashi Bengali will never have. And a Probashi Bengali generally holds on to a kind of a Bangla which is 30 or 40 years in the past. But the Bangla of Bengal, the Bangla of Calcutta, the Bangla of the Mufassils and all that is the current live evolving Bangla, about which I don't have much knowledge.
But is there a cultural sensibility that unites the Bengali diaspora, if I can call it a diaspora, a sense of, authentic art, culture, a certain aesthetic? Is there a Bengali aesthetic that you are part of when you make your cinema?
See, the thing is, I grew up in Karol Bagh in Delhi. So my aesthetic was as much Punjabi and Haryanvi and Bengali. Which is why my first film is not Boshbadi. You know, my first film is Khosla Ka Ghosla. And I can speak perhaps Punjabi a little more fluently. No, maybe as fluently as Bengali. So the thing is, I remember as a Probashi Bengali, perhaps one of the reasons why it stuck, why we sort of a kind of congregated around Durga Puja and congregated around other things was that we needed to maintain some kind of an identity in Delhi, which was our own, which is a typical migrant mentality about holding on to something which is like a time capsule. Mm-hmm. And there's always a phase lag in terms of what you are with culturally and in the migrant cities and what you are with culturally at the center of that culture. And there's always a time lag, phase lag. So that's why I'm not perhaps, I won't say good or bad, perhaps I'm not a correct Bengali, because I'm always a little away from the current mainstream cultural zeitgeist that's happening in Bengal and in Calcutta. I wouldn't know about that.
So essentially, you're more comfortable with the world of the Khoslas than the world of the Chatterjees. Right? The world of the Khoslas is what you were more comfortable with when depicting on cinema than the world of Chatterjees. What's the difference between a good Punjabi in Karol Bagh and you think, like your film Detective Byomkesh, about a sort of Bengal or a Kolkata of the past?
Yeah.
What's the difference?
Anxiety. I think being a Bengali and being living in my own family in Bengal as a migrant or something like that, I think Bengalis have a certain kind of a copyright on anxiety. And you don't see that much in a Punjabi household or with the friends that I grew up in my school or in my neighborhood. So that would happen, but...
A Bengali say the same thing?
I don't think he will ever say ki farak panda. I'm a Bengali and I'm anxious, by the way. I'm an extremely anxious person and I'm anxiety ridden. So I think that is the main thing. I mean, you worry about things.
I thought that was the pre-Saurav Ganguly Bengal. then suddenly the Bengali came to life, took his shirt off in the balcony of Lords. Yeah. I thought there was a new Bengali machismo emerging.
Well, there's an example of me not being a good Bengali, because I'm not up to date with what's the cool latest Bengali thing in Bangla, because I would know about Bombay or Delhi. Not about Bengal.
Okay, so we've titled this session Love, Hate, Politics, Art in the Age of Rage. You saw the rage on the screen on the stage just now. Trinamool versus CPM versus BJP.
It's not rage yet. I would call it enthusiasm. We'll see when the rage comes in. I mean, we'll see when it turns into rage.
Are you comfortable with watching these politicians play act on stage?
I'm used to it. We've been seeing it forever. And some of them may not be play acting. And since I've been on stages and panels, what happens is that when you're called to a stage, You're not only representing yourself, you're representing something that's behind you. It could be your party, it could be your ideology, it could be your profession, it could be your agenda. So you're anxious. You're anxious to clarify that agenda and clarify that ideology so that you're a good representative. And that's the stage. The stage makes you do that. Because you're not only speaking for yourself, you're speaking for some other things that lead to you being here.